Thank you. Actually, there is reading CS. I can leave a book up here. They want to use that. Otherwise, they're going to bring a book. That's up. Yeah, tell them I can leave it up here, and I can open up to the session.
Thank you. Don't burn the place.
Welcome to the parish of St. John Bosco. Today we share the joy of the families of our two Salesian deacons and the Salesian family of St. Philip the Apostle Province as we gather to pray to celebrate the ordination of our brothers, John Langan and Sasika Lokudice, to the priesthood. They will be ordained by the Most Reverend John O'Hara, Auxiliary Bishop of the Archdiocese of New York. We ask everyone to please switch off their cell phones, and we invite you all to participate fully and prayerfully in this moving and symbolic ceremony. There are designated photographers and videographers and live streaming persons for the occasion. Due to the health protocols, we ask you to refrain from taking pictures. Please do not leave your pews. After the proclamation of the gospel, please remain standing for the bishop to bless all with the book of the gospels. We also would like to call your attention to the guidelines for the reception of the communion listed on page 15 of your worship booklet. If you are not familiar with the Catholic Holy Communion, please take a moment to read over these guidelines. Let us begin our liturgy and celebrate. Now I ask you, please kindly stand.
Morning, good morning.
Thank you.
What's that good throat? The throat. The throat. God has been glory for my youth.
Go out to the altar of God, the God of our gladness and joy. Praise of the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord.
Everyone. My name is Father Tim. I'm the provincial of the Salesians of the SUE province of St. Philip the Apostle, which includes Canada and the Eastern United States. What a great joy it is for us all to be here together. That word joy has particular significance during this time when so many people are suffering and sad and separated. And yet, by God's grace, here we are together, united in prayer and spirit, and joyful because we're able to celebrate the ordinations of Deacon John to Father John, and Deacon Sasika to Father Sasika, priests of Jesus Christ. Welcome to all families, friends, members of the Salesian family to this beautiful church, St. John Bosco in Porchester. We'll have an opportunity to say thanks toward the end, but we'd also like to give a special welcome to an alumnus of Don Bosco Prep Ramsey, Bishop John O'Hara, who's with us today. When we sent out the letter of invitation a year ago or so, he responded very quickly. And over the course of the years, we've had an opportunity to speak by phone to make sure that things are on track. You know, things have gone crazy in the world, but Bishop O'Hara has been steady. I want to be there. And what a great joy, in addition to the ordinations, to have an alumnus, a member of Don Bosco's family with us for this beautiful celebration in the Church of St. John Bosco. So welcome, everybody. Welcome, Bishop O'Hara.
Thank you so much. It's good to be with you. And when I'm with the Salesians, I feel that I'm very much at home. Now, I studied at Don Bosco in ancient times, 1959 to 1963. That's when they found the Dead Sea Scrolls, all right? But that was a formative experience in my life, the Salesian fathers and the brothers and the lay faculty there. And in this Mass, I'm giving thanks to God for all of them. And somehow I feel that Don Bosco had a hand in all of this. And I'm so very, very, very grateful. I first want to begin by saying to you, John and Sasika, I spoke to my Archbishop, our Archbishop of New York, Timothy Michael Cardinal Dolan, this morning, and he asked me to assure you of his prayers and best wishes and congratulations to your families and to all the Salesian family. He loves the Salesians and is very grateful to all that the Salesians do here in the Archdiocese of New York. So as we're praying here today, Cardinal Dolan is praying for both of you and all of us. And that's just a great way to begin our celebration. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we joyfully come together today to pray this holy sacrifice of the Mass and to celebrate the ordination to the priesthood of Jesus Christ of John and Sasika, let us pause for a moment, call to mind our sins, and ask our good and gracious God for pardon and for peace. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord our God, who in governing your people make use of the ministry of priests, grant a persevering obedience to your will, to to these deacons of your church, John and Sasika, whom you graciously choose today for the office of the priesthood, so that by their ministry and life they may gain glory for you in Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Thank you very much. Okay. Thank you.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the afflicted, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, release to the prisoners, to announce a year of favor from the Lord and a day of vindication by our God, to comfort all who mourn, to place on those who mourn in Zion a diadem instead of ashes, to give them oil of gladness instead of mourning, a glorious mantle instead of a faint spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
The promises of the Lord I will sing forever. Through all generations my mouth shall proclaim your faithfulness. For you have said my kindness is established forever. In heaven you have confirmed your faithfulness.
Forever I will sing goodness of the Lord.
Blessed the people who know the joyful shout. In the light of your countenance, O Lord, they walk. At your name they rejoice all the day. And through your justice they are exalted.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
Hebrew Varunta Lianalata Hasanin Uputagat Pateki Samanaika Puja Kekma Pandarut Papa Pujat Opukirima Pinisa Suakia Senaga Atarin Toragena Own Venuin Devian Vahanse Sandahavu Katyutu Kirima Pinisa Patkaranulabai Ohut Durvala Kamvalata Bajana Visitina Bavin Anuananda Mulavenanda Gena Ivasilen Kriakiri Mata Ohuta Pilivana E Durvalakam Nisa Senaga Udesa Menma Tama Udesat Ohuvisin Papa Puja Opukiranu Labima Avashava Atta Tavada Aaron Men Devian Vahanse Visin Kandavanalada Ayamisa Ankisivek E Nilea Tamatama Pavaranogan Neya Esema Krishun Vahanset, Nayaka Pujakeku Vime Gauravaya, Taman Vahansema Pavarano Gatseka. Ehet, Obamage Putrayaya. Ada Mama Obajanita Kalami, Unvahanseta Kitanan Vahansema, E Gauravaya Pavaru Seka. Elesama, Venatanaka, oba Melchisek Pujaka Parapura Anua, Sadahatama, Pujakek Vannehiai, Ethanan Vahanse Vataarana Seka. Krisun Vahanse, Minisat Bavagena Sitiadi, Taman Maranen Galavanata, Pilivanvu, Tanan Vahanseta, Palavat Handi Menut, Kandulu Sali Menut, Yagnyada, Kannalauda, Oppukala Seka. Un Vahanseke Deva Garubia Nisa, Devian Vahanse, Eta Savandun Seka. Un Vahanse, Putreananvu Namut, Tamange, Tukvindimen, Kikarukama Igenagat Seka. Mese, Un Vahanse, Sampurnatve Labba, Taman Vahanse, Ta Kikaru, Sialange, Sadatana Vimukti Daikiano, Seka. Tavada, Melchisedek Pujaka Parapura Anuva, Uttama Pujaka Nameda, Devian Vahansegen Lat Seka. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. All right. You be blessed by him in whose honor you burn. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Well done, fellas. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Deacon, may the Lord be in your heart and on your lips, that you may worthily and well proclaim this holy gospel in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Finished breakfast, Jesus said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these? He said to him, yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Jesus said to him, feed my lambs. A second time he said to him, Simon, son of John, do you love me? He said to him, yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Jesus said to him, tend my sheep. He said to him the third time, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Peter felt hurt because he said to him the third time, do you love me? And he said to him, Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you. Jesus said to him, feed my sheep. Very truly, I tell you, when you were younger, you used to fasten your own belt and go wherever you wished. But when you grow old, you will stretch out your hands, and someone else will fasten a belt around you and take you where you do not wish to go. He said this to indicate the kind of death by which he would glorify God. After this, he said to him, follow me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Through the words of the Holy Gospel, may my sins be wiped away. Okay, now hold.
The calling and presentation of the candidates. At this time, the candidates are called forward and receive a blessing from their parents. The Salesian Provincial asks the bishop to ordain them to the responsibility of the priesthood and testifies to their worthiness. Then the bishop accepts the request of the people of God, show their consent by saying, thanks be to God, and applaud.
I'm all right. I'm fine. I just had to watch my eyes. That's all. Okay. Okay.
Let those to be ordained priests come forward. John Langan.
Present.
Sasika Lakuhetige.
Present.
Most Reverend Father, Holy Mother Church asks you to ordain these our brothers, John and Sasika, with the responsibility of the priesthood.
Father Tim, do you know them to be worthy?
After inquiry among the Christian people and upon the recommendation of those responsible, I testify that they have been found worthy.
Relying on the help of the Lord God and our Savior Jesus Christ, we choose these, our brothers, John and Sasika, for the order of the priesthood. Thanks be to God. I'm glad you sat. This part's long, huh? All right. Beloved brothers and sisters, because these are sons John and Sasika, who are your relatives and friends, are now to be advanced to the order of priests. Consider carefully the nature of the rank in the church to which they are about to be raised. It is true that God has made his entire holy people a royal priesthood in Christ. Nevertheless, our great priest himself, Jesus Christ, chose certain disciples to carry out publicly in his name and on behalf of mankind a priestly office in the church. For Christ was sent by the Father, and he in turn sent the apostles into the world so that through them and their successors, the bishops, he might continue to exercise his office of teacher, priest, and shepherd. Indeed, priests are established co-workers of the order of bishops with whom they are joined in the priestly office and with whom they are called to the service of the people of God. After mature deliberation, these our brothers John and Sasika are now to be ordained to the priesthood in the order of the presbyterate so as to serve Christ the teacher, priest, and shepherd, by whose ministry his body, that is, the church, is built and grows into the people of God, a holy temple. In being configured to Christ, the eternal high priest, and joined to the priesthood of the bishops, they will be consecrated as true priests of the New Testament to preach the gospel, to shepherd God's people, and to celebrate the sacred liturgy, especially the Lord's sacrifice. Now, dear sons, John, Sasika, you are to be raised to the order of the priesthood. For your part, you will exercise the sacred duty of teaching in the name of Christ the teacher. Impart to everyone the word of God which you have received with joy. Meditating on the law of the Lord, see that you believe what you read, that you teach what you believe, and that you practice what you teach. In this way, let what you teach be nourishment for the people of God. Let the holiness of your lives be a delightful fragrance to Christ's faithful, so that by word and example, you may build up the house which is God's church. Likewise, you will exercise in Christ the office of sanctifying, for by your ministry, the spiritual sacrifice of the faithful will be made perfect, being united to the sacrifice of Christ, which will be offered through your hands in an unbloody way on the altar, in union with the faithful, in the celebration of the sacraments. Understand, therefore, what you do, and imitate what you celebrate. As celebrants of the mystery of the Lord's death and resurrection, strive to put to death whatever in your members is sinful, and to walk in newness of life. Remember when you gather others into the people of God through baptism, and when you forgive sins in the name of Christ and the church in the sacrament of penance, when you comfort the sick with holy oil and celebrate the sacred rites, when you offer prayers of praise and thanks to God throughout the hours of the day, not only for the people of God, but for the whole world, remember then that you are taken from among men and appointed on their behalf for those things that pertain to God. Therefore, carry out the ministry of Christ the priest with constant joy and genuine love, attending not to your own concerns, but to those of Jesus Christ. Finally, dear sons, John and Sasika, exercising for your part the office of Christ, head and shepherd, while united with the bishop and subject to him, strive to bring the faithful together into one family so that you may lead them to God the Father through Christ in the Holy Spirit. Keep always before your eyes the example of the Good Shepherd who came not to be served, but to serve, and who came to seek out and save what was lost. Okay. I have a priest friend of mine who has a very, very unusual photo of St. John Bosco. I never saw it before. It obviously was taken late in Don Bosco's life. He's in the fullness of years, a bit unshaven, stubbly beard. The beretta on his head is crushed and cockeyed. And there is a whimsical grim, a whimsical smile on the face of Don Bosco, and would you believe, a wink of the eye. I like that picture. It's better than a holy card because it speaks of a man who was filled with joy. Not the kind of joy that the world gives that is fleeting and passing and sometimes destructive, but a real joy knowing full well the triumph of Christ, the triumph of the cross, the resurrection, that power of Jesus is imparted to you and to me. We experience resurrection even in the troubled times we live in through the mystery of the sacraments. He knew that, he believed that, he lived that. In troubled times, in difficult circumstances, not unlike our own, the secret to Don Bosco's joy is the secret of the Eucharist. That's the foundation. That's the anchor. The second is his devotion to Mary, the help of Christians, through the rosary. The rosary is the lifeline, really and truly. As you begin now and you take steps toward ordination, just a few moments with the laying on of hands, follow his example. Surrender all your fears, your worries, your brokenness, your difficulties, as he did. Put them right into the heart of the Eucharistic Lord and ask the intercession of Mary, the help of Christians, to help you on the way. Oh, the joy that the Lord will give you is immense if you do that each and every single day. May I share with you a thought of Cardinal O'Connor, too, who ordained me 36 years ago. We were his first class when he became Archbishop of New York. He always emphasized the importance of the daily Mass. Whether there's 500 people in the church or whether you are alone, he said, that is what defines you and me and all of us as priests. And I remember O'Connor telling us very directly, a day without the Mass for him was a day that was not lived. It was a man who was a great priest and a great joy and a great leader, a great teacher of the faith. Don Bosco was filled with the joy. The joy comes from the Eucharist. The strength comes from Mary, help of Christians. Make that your joy. Make her your strength. And just in closing these remarks, may I share with you the last fervorino given by the late Father Benedict Rochelle, a good friend of mine, Franciscan Friars of the Renewal. A priest friend of mine went to visit Father Benedict 2 days before he passed to the Lord 6 years ago. And Father Benedict realized the priest was in turmoil. And he said, Father Gene, what's bothering you? What's upsetting you? What's on your mind? Why are you down in the dumps? Father Gene, don't be afraid of anything. Christ is victor. John Zizika, don't be afraid of anything. Christ is victor. Let him be victor in you and you. And may you live that victory and share that with the people to whom the Lord sends you. God bless you. Godspeed. Congratulations, and thank you for inviting me to celebrate this most special and sacred moment with you.
Okay. The Litany of the Supplication. The bishop now invites the assembly to pray that God will pour out the gifts of heaven on Sasika and John, who God has chosen for the office of priest. The bishop will now question Deacon Sasika and John, asking them to declare their resolve to accept the duty and responsibilities of the priesthood. The candidates kneel before the bishop and promise respect and obedience to the diocesan bishop and the provincial.
Dear sons, John and Sasika, before you enter the order of the priesthood, you must declare before the people your intention to undertake this office. John and Sasika, do you resolve, with the help of the Holy Spirit, to discharge without fail the office of priesthood in the presbyteral rank as worthy fellow workers with the order of bishops in caring for the Lord's flock?
I do.
Do you resolve to exercise the ministry of the word worthily and wisely, preaching the gospel and teaching the Catholic faith?
I do.
Do you resolve to celebrate faithfully and reverently in accord with the Church's tradition the mysteries of Christ, especially the sacrifice of the Eucharist and the sacrament of reconciliation, for the glory of God and the sanctification of the Christian people?
I do.
Do you resolve to implore with us God's mercy upon the people entrusted to your care by observing the command to pray without ceasing?
I do.
And do you resolve to be united more closely every day to Christ the High Priest, who offered himself for us to the Father as a pure sacrifice, and with him to consecrate yourself to God for the salvation of all?
I do, with the help of God.
Okay. John and Sasika, do you promise respect and obedience to the diocesan bishop and to your legitimate superior? We'll try that again. All right. I didn't pay attention to Father Manny. All right, I'm going to get it right here. Let's go to the top. We'll do it again. John, do you promise respect and obedience to the diocesan bishop and to your legitimate superior?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. We got it right that time. Okay. Okay. Sasika, do you promise respect and obedience to the diocesan bishop and to your legitimate superior?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. You got it right. Okay, good.
The bishop now invites the assembly to pray that God will pour out the gifts of heaven on Sasika and John, who God has chosen for the office of priest. They will prostrate themselves in an act of humble prayer, and a litany of the saints is sung. This prayer asks for the intercession of the saints in order that God may look favorably upon those to be ordained. A prayer follows asking the Holy Spirit may be poured out upon them. While these prayers are being prayed, the faithful are to join their prayers for the candidates to those of the bishop.
My dear people, let us pray that God, the all-powerful Father, will pour out abundantly the gifts of heaven on these his servants, John and Sasika, whom he has chosen for the office of priest.
At this time, I ask you, please kneel.
Pray for us.
apostles and evangelists.
Pray for us.
Saint Mary Magdalene.
Pray for us.
All holy disciples of the Lord.
Pray for us.
Saint Stephen and Lawrence.
Pray for us.
Saints Perpetua and Felicity.
Pray for us.
Saint Agnes.
Pray for us.
Saint Aloysius Versiglia.
Pray for us.
Saint Callistus Caravario.
Pray for us.
Blessed Joseph Kowalski.
Pray for us.
Blessed Jose Calasanz and companions.
Pray for us.
Blessed Francis Kisi and companions.
Pray for us.
Blessed Stephen Sandor.
Pray for us.
Blessed Titus Simon.
Pray for us.
Oh, holy martyrs of Christ.
Pray for us.
Saint Basil.
Pray for us.
Saint Augustine.
Pray for us. Pray for us.
Saint Bernard.
Pray for us.
Saint Francis.
Pray for us.
Saint Dominic.
Pray for us.
Saint Ignatius of Loyola.
Pray for us.
Saint Francis de Sales.
Pray for us.
Saint Vincent de Paul.
Pray for us.
Saint John Bosco.
Pray for us.
Saint Catherine of Siena.
Pray for us.
Saint Teresa of Jesus.
Pray for us. Pray for us.
Saint John of the Cross.
Pray for us.
Saint Mary Dominica Mazzarello.
Pray for us.
Saint Dominic Savio.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph Confesso.
Pray for us. Pray for us.
Saint Louis Orion.
Pray for us.
Blessed Laura Vicuna.
Pray for us.
Blessed Michael Rua.
Pray for us.
Blessed Philip Rinaldi.
Pray for us. Pray for us.
Blessed Artemides Adi.
Pray for us.
Blessed Madeline Murano.
Pray for us.
Blessed Maria Truncati.
Pray for us.
Blessed Maria Romero Meneses.
Pray for us. Pray for us.
Blessed Eusebia Palomino.
Pray for us.
Blessed Alexandrina M. DeCosta.
Pray for us.
Blessed Albert Marvelli.
Pray for us.
Blessed Bronislaw Markowitz.
Pray for us. Pray for us.
Blessed Louise Guanella.
Pray for us.
All saints and blessed. blessed of the Salesian family.
Pray for us.
All holy men and women, saints of God.
Pray for us.
Service to your church.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bless these chosen men.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bless and sanctify these chosen men.
Lord, we ask you, hear our Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bring all peoples together in peace and true harmony.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Comfort with your mercy the troubled and the afflicted.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Hear us, we beseech you, Lord our God, and pour out on these servants of yours, John and Sasika, the blessing of the Holy Spirit and the power of priestly grace, that those whom, in the sight of your mercy, we offer to be consecrated may be surrounded by your rich and unfailing gifts through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The laying of the hands. In silence, the bishop will now impose hands on Deacon John and Deacon Sasika. This essential action comes to the church from the scriptures and tradition and signifies the conferral of God's Holy Spirit, through whose power the church ordains those who are called to serve in the order of priests. All the priests will then lay hands upon them. This communal laying on hands
is symbolize the fact that they will be ordained in a Presbyterian college. The prayer of consecration. With this prayer, the bishop continues what was begun in the laying on of the hands, bestowing the priestly office on the candidates. It alludes to Aaron and the 70 elders called by Moses as Old Testament figures that prefigure the presbyters who will work as co-workers of the bishop. The prayer is directed to the Father, who by the prayer of the Holy Spirit provides for the various forms of the ministry within the Church of Christ. While this prayer is being prayed, the faithful join their prayers silently to those of the bishop. Once this prayer is concluded, the men will be ordained as priests. Please stand.
Draw near, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, author of human dignity. It is you who apportion all graces. Through you, everything progresses. Through you, all things are made to stand firm. To form a priestly people, you appoint ministers of Christ your Son, by the power of the Holy Spirit, arranging them in different orders. Already in the earlier covenant, offices arose, established through mystical rites. When you set Moses and Aaron over your people to govern and sanctify them, you chose men next in rank and dignity to accompany them and assist them in their task. So too, in the desert, you implanted the spirit of Moses in the hearts of 70 wise men, and with their help, he ruled your people with greater ease. So also upon the sons of Aaron, you poured an abundant share of their father's plenty, that the number of the priests prescribed by the law might be sufficient for the sacrifices of the tabernacle, which were a shadow of the good things to come. But in these last days, Holy Father, you sent your Son into the world, Jesus, who is apostle and high priest of our confession. Through the Holy Spirit, he offered himself to you as a spotless victim, and he made his apostles consecrated in the truth, sharers in his mission. You provided them also with companions to proclaim and carry out the work of salvation throughout the whole world. And now we beseech you, Lord, in our weakness, to grant us these helpers that we need to exercise the priesthood that comes from the apostles. Grant, we pray, Almighty Father, to these your servants the dignity of the priesthood. Renew deep within them the spirit of holiness. May they henceforth possess this office which comes from you, O God, and is next in rank to the office of bishop. And by the example of their manner of life, may they instill right conduct. May they be worthy co-workers with our order, so that by their preaching and through the grace of the Holy Spirit, the words of the gospel may bear fruit in human hearts and reach even to the ends of the earth. Together with us, may they be faithful stewards of your mysteries, so that your people may be renewed in the waters of rebirth and nourished from your altar, so that sinners may be reconciled and the sick raised up. May they be joined with us, Lord, in imploring your mercy for the people entrusted to their care and for all the world. And so may the full number of nations gathered together in Christ be transformed into your one people and made perfect in your kingdom. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
Please be seated.
Okay, sure. Thank you. going well.
The investiture with the stole and a chasuble. For the first time, the newly ordained priests are vested with the signs of their office. Another priest assists in this and helps a new priest to put on a chasuble. This is the proper vestment for the priest and the bishop to wear for the celebration of the Eucharist. It is given to a priest because only he and the bishop may validly celebrate the Mass. He is to wear this whenever he presides at the Mass. The anointing of hands. The bishop now anoints the hands of the newly ordained priest with holy chrism to signify the priest's ministry in the church. In the church is to heal, to sanctify, and to offer prayer for God's people. This anointing is a symbol of the anointing with the Holy Spirit, which took place through the imposition of hands and the prayer of the ordination. It also symbolizes the priest's distinctive participation in Christ's priesthood by the sacrifice he will offer with his hands.
Father John, the Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve you, that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifice to God. Father Sasika, the Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve you, that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifice to God. We used a lot of oil.
The presentation of the purificator. The new priest will now present the purificators used to cleanse the holy chrism from the hands to their moms. The tradition is that at death of their moms, this purificator is buried with her, a sign that she was the mother of the priest.
Okay, here we go. Oh, yeah. Let's go the whole port and just a little more. All right. Now we have the. Okay, we do this. All right, there you go. Now we have. I'm getting punished for using all that oil. All right, good. Let's take a little bit off. All right. I'm sorry. Okay. I'm going to stay right here. Sure.
The handing over of the bread and the wine. At this time, the parents of Father John and Father Sasika will present to the bishop the gifts of the bread and wine. The bishop, in turn, presents these gifts to the newly ordained priest as a sign of their ministry, saying as he does so, "Receive from the holy people of God the gifts to be offered to God. Know what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross." This gesture ties the rite of the ordination directly to the Eucharistic context and to the priest's service on behalf of the people of God.
Father John, receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross. Father Sasika, receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross.
Presbyterial greeting of peace.
Well,
the bishop and other priests extend a sign of peace to the newly ordained, welcoming them to the order of priest. The Mass now continues as usual. The newly ordained now serve as a concelebrant with the bishop. This is the first Mass that they will celebrate.
Thank you for giving me this gift.
Yeah.
Spirit has watched the steps. It's not my feet, it's my eyes. Okay.
You are a priest forever. Consecrated to the service of the Lord, to sit at his right hand. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. Persona Christi ad meorum Dei gloriam totus tuus, amen. Beneath the mantle of your mother, who intercedes on your behalf, consecrated to the service of the Lord, to sit at his right hand. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. In persona Christi ad meorum Dei gloriam totus tuus, amen. Lord, pour out upon this servant your Holy Spirit from above, the grace and power of your priesthood, and your unfailing love. May the anointing of the Lord be upon your brow today.
And cleanse me from my sins. You're doing fine. Can you catch?
May the olive branch of peace be raised in your right hand, that you might show
the book move closer to me, please. I'm having trouble seeing.
Of his love. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. In persona Christi ad meorum Dei gloriam totus tuus, amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Amen. O God, who have willed that your priests should minister at the holy altar and serve your people. Grant by the power of this sacrifice, we pray, that the labors of your servants, John and Sasika, may constantly please you and in your church bear that fruit which lasts forever through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son High Priest of the new and eternal covenant, and by your wondrous design were pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the church. For Christ not only adorns with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness, he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with your word and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you, and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. My Lord, in Jesus Christ, I believe. Trust in you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Jesus, mercy. Lord Jesus, thank you. the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint John Bosco, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Timothy our Bishop, with Bishop John and the assistant bishops, with the order of bishops, these your servants John and Sasika, who have been ordained today as priests for the church, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children, scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
At this time, due to health protocols, we cannot exchange a sign of peace. However, Father John and Father Sasika will go to extend peace to their immediate family.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ be made safe for eternal life. Amen. Blood of Christ, keep me safe for eternal life. Amen.
The body and blood of Christ will be brought to the concelebrating priest first. After they have received, Father John and Father Sasika will distribute the Eucharist. Please form one single line coming down the center of the aisle, maintaining distance as you come forward.
Okay, thank you.
Receive from the priest of your choice. If you receive in a hand, you may not wear gloves. Return to your seats by the side aisles. Thank you.
Has venido a la orilla, no has buscado ni a sabios ni a ricos, tan solo quieres que yo te siga, Señor.
Lord, take my hands and direct.
other shores.
De la aurora tu sorgi più bella, coi tuoi raggi fra lieta la terra, e fra gli estri benedetti intera, non viste la più bella.
pray. May the divine sacrifice we have offered and received, O Lord, give new life to your priests and to all your servants, especially Father John and Father Sasika, on this day of their ordination, that united to you in unfailing love, they may receive the grace of giving worthy service to your majesty through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for words of gratitude from Father Provincial.
It's my privilege to express some gratitude to so many people who have been involved in this celebration, but not only in this particular day. We're here to give thanks primarily to God, of course. The Eucharist is thanksgiving. God, the source of all that is good. God, the one who calls. We know that vocation is a calling. It is the gift of a call. And Sasika and John, Father Sasika, Father John, have accepted that gift, have said yes to the call. And so we thank God, we thank our newly ordained priests. The vocation doesn't rise up of itself, by its isolated, but in the setting of a family, the setting of a spiritual family, the setting of a natural family. And so we have to, in a very special way, say thank you to the families that have nurtured the love of God in the home, have also welcomed the gift of the vocation, have supported John and Sasika in answering their call. So I think our families, the Langen family and Sasika's family, deserve are well-deserving of a round of applause from all of us. We know that John's mother and father and other members of, Sasika's mother and father and other members of his family weren't able to join us today in person, but they are with us virtually, so we welcome them and greet them through Facebook and through the other means of social communication. Don Bosco founded a spiritual family, a Salesian family, and so we want to thank the extended members of the family gathered here today, and especially Father Pat, Father Manny, the St. John Bosco of Porchester family who have opened their doors and made this such a wonderful celebration, a welcoming environment of dedicated service to God and the young, the altar servers, the musicians, the technicians, the Hermandad Señora de los Milagros, so many people who have come together to serve in this parish community, this family of Don Bosco. So thank you, Father Pat, and everyone who's come together to help us today. And of course, a word of thanks to His Excellency. He doesn't like it when we say that, because he's more of a brother and a father than His Excellency, but he's still, for us, a bishop and a father, and a brother. We want to thank Bishop O'Hara for being with us. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I mentioned that God, the source of all that is good, is the one who continually calls. So I put out a challenge to the young people today, to our altar servers, to all the young people who are with us, to attune your ears to the voice of Jesus, the Good Shepherd, and follow the example of Father John and Father Sasika. Listen carefully to what Jesus is saying in your heart, and like them, say yes. Yes to the call. Accept the gift of the vocation, and you'll find, as the bishop has said, great joy, great happiness that lasts forever.
Thanks, Father Tim, for your words. I'm getting agoraphobia sitting up here on top of this altar here. Holy smokes. Anyway, it's time for me to go to the eye doctor because I'm having trouble seeing the stairs. But wasn't this something today? Wasn't it great? We all needed this. Father John, Father Sika, you are joyful men. And I just want to leave you with one thought. Don Bosco had a motto over his desk, I think that you know, give me souls, take away the rest. And that was a key to spirituality, the shortest distance between two points. In an age where there's division, where there's hurt, where there's anger, where there's bitterness, where people have been reduced to nothing, Don Bosco always saw every human person created in the image and likeness of God, redeemed by Jesus Christ with the potential for salvation, and he was a bridge builder. We don't need to be stumbling blocks, we need to be stepping stones. And I would hope through the prayers of St. John Bosco that he who was like a compass pointing to Jesus Christ, he will guide you that motto, give me souls, take away the rest, that you will see in each and every person that you touch, that image of Jesus calling, pleading, reaching out, that you'll be the bridge builder that will open to them those gates of grace and mercy that they so desperately need. You know, the times that Don Bosco lived in were not unlike our own. A lot of anger, a lot of cynicism, a lot of political unrest inside the church, outside the church, all over the place, and he kept right on target. Archbishop Sheen always made the point of saying that we're kind of like a faithful remnant, if you will, and we're in a small boat in heavy seas. But he says, always remember that the wood of that boat was drenched with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. And that will bring us through the storm and ultimately bring us to safe harbor. So John, Father Zizika, thank you so very much. I got to tell you something, too. This is the first time I've ordained a priest, two priests. First time. I want to thank Father Manny for getting me through it. Somebody asked me, how did you become a bishop? I said, I don't know. I picked up the phone one day, and there was a guy on the other end who said, the Pope just appointed you a bishop. What do you have to say? Do you want it or not? And I kind of thought that this was a joke, and it wasn't. It was the nuncio. But I've always felt, my classmate Bishop Byrne, who got the same call the same day, that they were having a bad day in the Vatican, the day they appointed the two of us bishops, because we were, what do we know about all of this bishop stuff? And I was convinced it was a sign that the end times were near, really and truly. But this has been a joy being with all of you because it's not been a ritual, it's been a celebration, and I hope maybe that the spirit of Don Bosco will fill all of us as we go out into a world that desperately needs his love, and you and I can be icons of his presence. With the help of Mary, a couple of Christians, and the prayers of Don Bosco, may that happen in you and in me. And one last thing to our new priests, I'm following Father Manny's instructions, but after you give the blessings, we're going to do something that Cardinal O'Connor did when I was ordained, and he did it with every ordination that he ever did when he was Archbishop of New York. He asked the newly ordained to come with the Cardinal and give the blessing at the end of the Mass, and I want you to do that. And we'll do that from right in front of the altar, all right? We've got a deal? Okay, fine. We're going to do that. All right. Okay. The Lord be with you. Bow down now for the blessing. May God, who founded the church and guides her still, protect you constantly in his grace, that you may faithfully discharge the duties of the priesthood. Amen. May he make you servants and witnesses in the world to divine charity and truth and faithful ministers of reconciliation.
Amen.
And may he make you true shepherds to provide the living bread and word of life to the faithful, that they may continue to grow in unity of the body of Christ.
Amen. At this time, before the final blessing of the Mass, our new priests will give their first blessing to the bishop, Father Provincial, and other main celebrants.
Okay. Where do we go? Okay, here we go. All right.
Maria,
And I'm going to ask Father John and Father Zizika to join me in the final blessing on this, their ordination day. And I know I speak for you in wishing them Godspeed and multos anos, many, many years of service. And we pray also that other young men, inspired by their example, might answer the call to service. And now, may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever and ever. Amen. Thanks be to God.
The bishop, our new priest, and the other concelebrants will not recess out of the church, but will come forward for a picture. We ask, please, one should come forward to take pictures at this time. No one should come forward at this time. Due to health protocols, everyone is asked to remain in their seats. After the pictures, Father John and Father Sasika will remain for a few minutes if anyone wishes to receive their first priestly blessing. For those invited to the reception, it follows immediately in the parish gym around the corner on Washington Street. There are persons outside to direct you. Thank you for your cooperation, and everyone have a great day.
We will send the message, we will be the witness.